I'm Rosanna, the artist and designer behind Bikinis Crochet, and in today's video I'm going to be giving you a free crochet pattern on how to make a crochet frangipani. So, let's get started. Okay, for this tutorial you're going to need a crochet hook. Now I've got two here because I've made two different sizes of frangipani. So you'll need a crochet hook suitable for your yarn, some scissors, your needle, and some yarn. Now, because I made two different sizes, I've used two different types of yarn. For the video, I've used not much thicker yarn, which I'll like show you in a second, but for all the frangipanis that I've made, I've used this yarn, which is a 4-ply yarn, which is really very thin, quite delicate. That is why I have used a 2.5 crochet needle to create quite tight knots, to create this small, say 4.5 centimeter diameter frangipani. For the video tutorial, I have used a much thicker yarn so it is clearer for you to see on the video. So here are both yarns together. You can see one is much thicker than the other. I'd say this is more a double worsted yarn, and I've used cotton. And for the video, I've used a 5mm hook. And this has created a frangipani of about 9 centimeters in diameter. So it's much bigger. Okay, let's start the pattern. Okay, so let's start with our yarn. So the first two rows are made using a yellow yarn, because I'm making a white and yellow frangipani. So let's start. We're going to start with our first chain stitch, as so. Okay. Now we need to chain three. So one, two, three. So I've got three chains in my stitch. Now I'm going to slip stitch into the first chain, as so, and pull it all the way through, and it creates a tiny little circle which we're going to work into later. So next step is we need to chain five. One, two, three, four, five. So now these five chains you're going to count as one double crochet and two chains. So the one, two, three is going to be your double crochet, and the last two will count as two chain stitches. Okay. Now what you need to do is double crochet, so hook over. We're going to double crochet right into the center of this knot. It doesn't need to be exact, just push your hook through and it will make a hole. Pull it through and continue your double crochet stitch. So we look like this, and now chain two. One, two. Now we're going to repeat that step, double crochet into the center of your circle, pull it up, and then two chains. One, two. Three double crochets. Once again, double crochet into the center, chain two. One, two, and once more. So double crochet into the center, chain two. Now we've got five double crochets. One, two, three, four, five. What you need to do, we're going to close the circle now. So we're going to slip stitch into the third stitch from our first step. One, two, three. And then slip stitch into here to create a little wheel with five spokes. One, two, three, four, five. Now, for the second row, we're not going to work flat, we're going to work vertical. So, first of all, what I find easiest to do is I turn it to the side So my double crochet stitch I can pull. So I can pull this apart. And then we're going to work into this double crochet. Now normally when you make a circle, you work from the previous row and you go flat outwards. But this time we're creating a 3D flower. So pull that double crochet stitch up if it makes it easier for you to see. So I've just pulled it up just here, and that's easier for me to see. That's my tail, move that way. So here's my double crochet stitch from our first row. I'm going to slip stitch into here, so underneath, and I'm going to chain two. One, two. Now I'm going to double crochet three times into this bar. So double crochet once, twice. Now third time. So now I've got three double crochets in this bar. One, two, three. Plus I'll chain two from the start. Now to close this, we're going to do another chain two. One, two, and slip stitch back underneath in this bar. So now if you turn this flat, you've got a vertical, like little fin or fan coming out of your first row. So now chain three, one, two, three. I'm going to slip stitch back into the bar of the top of the chain. Not into the double crochet, into the top. So let's slip stitch underneath. That creates our first petal, which is now 3D. It's not flat. Okay, now we're going to repeat this process on each double crochet. So again, turn it to the side, lift your double crochet up so it's easier for you to see, and slip stitch under. That's our slip stitch. Chain two, one, two. Now double crochet three times. Here's my first double crochet. My second, my third, and I'm going to chain two again to close this stitch. One, two. And slip stitch back underneath the same double crochet spoke. Okay, turn, chain three, one, two, three, and we're going to slip stitch underneath the bar of the two chains of our first row. So now we've got two petals. So I'm going to repeat this process again. Here's our third double crochet. Lift it to the side. Slip stitch under. Chain two. Double crochet three times. One. Two. Three. Now chain two, one, two, slip stitch underneath the same double crochet. Now chain three, one, two, three, and slip stitch again underneath the top bar. Okay, now we've got three petals, one, two, three. Now once again, slip stitch underneath your double crochet bar, one, two chains, three double crochet, one, sorry, I just need to get some more yarn. So that's our first double crochet, second, now third. Chain two, one, two, slip stitch underneath the same bar. Now we've got four petals, chain three, two, three, slip stitch under the chain bar, the first row. Okay, now this is our last petal. Turn to the side, find your double crochet bar, slip stitch, chain two, one, two, double crochet three times, one, two. Three. Now chain two, slip stitch back underneath double crochet and chain three. One, two, three, and slip stitch underneath top bar. And now we can cut the yarn. Pull my yarn through with the hook. And now, if I turn this out, I've got five petals. One, two, three, four, five, which are all naturally going round in a wheel and spoke. Okay. I find it easier now to weave in your ends. Okay, so now I've weaved in my ends, and as you can see, the first two rows creates a little flower. So we've got one, two, three, four, five petals, and they're all going round, and it's much more popping out of you. It's 3D, it's not a flat flower. So next stage, we're going to start to add our white yarn to finish our flower. Let's add our white yarn. Now you can add your white yarn to any of these bars. It doesn't matter where you start in your flower, as long as it's one of the space bars here. So I'm going to start here. So I'm going to pick my white yarn. I'm going to slip it through. Now hold on to the tail. Okay. Now chain one. Oh, doesn't want to catch. Okay, chain one. Now we're going to single crochet into our chain two bar of the previous row. Single crochet inside the bar, not into a stitch. And now we're going to double crochet into the stitch this time, the previous row. So double crochet twice into this stitch. So it's a double crochet increase. That's one double crochet increase. That's two double crochets in one stitch. Okay, I'm going to repeat this, so a double crochet increase. That's two double crochets. One, two. So now I've got four double crochets here. Now I'm going to do the same in the last stitch here. Double crochet increase, so two double crochets, one, two. So I've got one, two, three, four, five, six double crochets in this petal so far. Now, to finish the petal, we're going to work into our chain two bar, not into the stitch, and we're going to single crochet into here. And then this time, we're going to work into the circle that we started with, our foundation circle. So, look carefully. Use your hook and go through the center of your circle. So mine is here. I'm going to push it through, and I'm going to pull out the side, not all the way to the back. So it's going through the center, into the side. And I'm going to grab my white yarn to make a slip stitch. So I've got a slip stitch right into the center of my foundation. Now I'm going to chain three, one, two, three, and go up, back up to my space bar. So I'm going to slip stitch into here. And that is my first petal done. So if you can see that, they naturally turn the way the crochet is, so it's facing me, but I'll try and show you as clearly as I can. So let's do our next petal. So chain one, single crochet into the chain two bar, double crochet increase into the stitch. So it's one, two. And again for the next stitch, double crochet increase double crochet increase. So we've got 6 double crochets over this stitch. Now we're going to single crochet into our chain 2 bar. Into the bar, not into the stitch. So single crochet, chain 1. Now, like before, we're going to work back into our center chain. So go into the center of the circle, out to the side, grab your yarn and pull through. That's our second petal, nearly finished. Let's chain 3, 1, 2, 3, bring it up to the bar and slip stitch. So now I've got 2 petals done. So continue this process all the way around until you get to your 5th petal. Okay, so now I've done my 5 petals. So I just want to show the last little step here. So I've chained 3 up until my space bar, and I've slip stitch into that bar. Now, just to finish it off so it's even, what I'm going to do is slip stitch into my first slip stitch that I made. This might be a bit tight, but you just pull it through, and there we go. And then just cut your yarn and weave in your ends. So, here's a quick view of your flower so far. So I'll show you in a second after I've weaved in my ends. Okay, so here's your finished frangipani flower. So what I did, I just teased out the petals just to bring them back because they want to turn forward after doing your work. So just tease them back, and there you go, is one finished frangipani. Now this is made with the bigger yarn that I told you about in the beginning. So this is quite large, I'd say about 8 centimeters in diameter. But this is the size of the frangipanis I made using 4-ply yarn. So it's a big size difference in size. So you can choose whether you want to do it with the bigger yarn or the smaller yarn. I hope you've enjoyed this video. And if you'd like to see more of my videos, whether it be from my crochet bikinis or free patterns, please subscribe in the link below on YouTube. Thank you for joining me today, and I hope you've enjoyed this pattern and it is clear. If you have any comments, please leave them in the comments section below and I'll get back to you. Thank you. Bye.